the nationalist and freedom fighter who was a lawyer by profession was taking active part in the Indian freedom struggle just for 8 years. But his contributions were so immense that people fondly called him Desh Bandhu, which means friend of the nation. He was the founder leader of the Swaraj Party. Netaji Bose was his disciple. Were you able to guess? Here is the answer. It is Desh Bandhu Chittaranjan Das.
This magnetic personality could speak so influentially that anybody who listens to him would fall flat for a speech. He was born on 5th November 1870 in Bikrampur village of Dhaka of Bangladesh, the then part of undivided India. His parents were Bhuban Mohan Das and Srimati Durga Mohan Das. His father was well educated, a solicitor and a journalist. He was also an active member of Brahmo Samaj and this paved foundation for the reformative and nationalistic thoughts in the minds of young Chittaranjan. He was married to Basanti Devi, who also took active part in the Indian freedom struggle and was one of the first few women to be arrested for taking part in the non-cooperation movement. After his schooling, he wanted to study law, which he did at Middle Temple, London. It was in London that he befriended like-minded people like Aurobindo Ghosh, Atul Prasad Sen and Sarojini Naidu, and together they promoted Dadabhai Navroji in the British Parliament. His law career was very brief. However, all the cases that he argued were looked at and admired for his powerful points and counter-argument. It was in 1917 that he started taking active part in the Indian freedom struggle. As a lawyer, he wore expensive suits which were shipped to Paris to be dry cleaned. But to show his support to the Swadeshi movement and to initiate a ban on the British-made goods, he himself set an example by burning his expensive suit in the streets and chose to be a Qadi. He sacrificed all his luxury when he joined the Indian Freedom Movement. He strongly used the printing media to express his views against the unfair laws of the British being imposed on India. He believed strongly in the constitutional approach to free India and believed that education is the only tool to achieve the same. He was the president of Indian National Congress but resigned the same at Gaya, as he was against no council entry recommended by Mahatma Gandhi as a part of non-cooperation movement. It was then he started the Swaraj Party. He was instrumental in running a non-official inquiry commission against the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which gave hot shivers to the British that they set up an inquiry commission for the same fearing massive protest. His knowledge of the legal aspects was so profound that he could able to connect legal violations to make up a clean petition which would be hard to oppose. He was an excellent poet and a powerful writer. During the troubled times of the Indian freedom struggle, he published 2 volumes of his poetry collection titled Malancha and Mala. In 1913, he published Sagar Sangeet, the Song of the Sea. When he knew that Sri Aurobindo was in dire need of money at Pondicherry, he readily offered him 1,000 rupees as a token of his support for the English translation of one of his poems. According to him, freedom is that condition in which a particular nation can identify its own individual existence. It was in 1925 that his health started to fail due to overwork. He went to Darjeeling to recoup his health, where he passed away on 16th June 1925. Bande Mataram!